Hey everyone, welcome. My name is Dmytro Mrzhensky, and in this video we will try to dive a little bit deeper into the bootstrapping process of Angular. We will investigate a little bit the source code, and there we will explore some lifecycle hook that will help you eventually to conditionally load the root component for your application. If it sounds interesting to you, then let's get started. Alright guys, before we start coding, let's quickly discuss what we're going to implement in this video. And imagine I've got two versions of one application. So I have pro version and some basic one. And depending on some conditions, I want to bootstrap either pro version or basic version of the application. So I hope it's pretty much clear. And this is how everything looks in the source code. So I have one module, I have two components, each of these components represent basic or pro version of the application. It might be something like mobile version of the application and desktop version. So use your imagination. But in my case, it will be pro and basic versions. So those are empty Angular component. There is only a few styles, like pro version has a dark background and the free version or basic version has blue background, so we can visually distinguish them. But both are empty components. And I have one app module, and as you can see, the app component that represents pro version is being bootstrapped. So currently, my app component is kind of root component, but as I said, depending on some certain conditions, sometimes I need to bootstrap a basic component as a root component for the application, right? And let's maybe quickly rename app component to something like pro app component, so it will be easier to understand what we're talking about. All right, cool. Now, guys, I could give you immediately the solution and say goodbye to you, and that's it. If you are looking for the solution only, you can use this time code or find it in the video description and jump over this section. But usually what I want to is to explain why things are working as they work. And for that, I would suggest you to investigate a little bit the bootstrapping process of the Angular application. We will not cover everything, yeah, but we will have a look at some key moments, and those findings will eventually help us to come to the feature that will help us to implement what we actually have to implement. And by the way, guys, in the end of the video, please let me know in the comments if you like this approach when we go from source code to some certain feature, and not like it usually happens when you see the feature and then we investigate the internal mechanics. For me, it's kind of small experiment, and I would like to hear your feedback, and I would highly, highly appreciate it. But let's move forward. The bootstrapping process happens inside main.ts file. You can see here we create, first of all, the platform, and already inside this platform we bootstrapping our Angular applications calling bootstrap module method. Now let's dive into the source code of this method and have a look what processes are happening there. All right, so here is the source code. There is the method that we call inside our main.ts file. This method belongs to platform ref service. As you can see, it's just a regular Angular service that you can even inject in your, components or in other services. And let's have a look what is happening inside bootstrap module. So there happens some compilation of module factory, whatever it does. And when it is done, we call bootstrap module factory. And where it is, here we go. This is the place where happens creation of ng zone, as you can see. Then exception handler is being set up, and we run app initializers that are covered in the previous video, by the way. If you are interested, you can have a look this video later. And once all initializers are like finished, then happens bootstrapping the module. And we can go inside, and here quite interesting things are happening. And let's get started from this very first if statement, which says that if the length of the bootstrap components array is more than zero, then Angular goes in for each loop through each element and calls bootstrap method for it. This bootstrap component's property is nothing else as this array we declared in our app module, right? So it means that we can bootstrap not only one single component, but we can bootstrap multiple components like that. Let's try to save this change and have a look if it works, and it shouldn't, because yeah, we have a runtime error because there is no proper selector for basic component. We have the selector app basic, so we should add it inside index.html file next to maybe app root component like that. And now if we reload the page, you can see that error disappeared and we bootstrapped two kind of root components, but do not treat them as two separate applications, because it is not. It's just two root components within one Angular application. They have a common ngson instance, they have a common module, they have common change detection. So yeah, it's just two root components for one application. Of course, we could bootstrap them as a two completely separated Angular applications running on the same page. And I could even show you how to do that in some future video, but I don't know if you would be interested in it. So maybe you could give me some hint, and if we could reach 800 likes under this video, then I would definitely understand that this topic is interesting and I would create a dedicated video. But let's move forward and let's have a look what else is hidden inside the Angular source code. So I go back, and here is the first if statement we just saw in action, right? And here below there is another else if statement that will be invoked if bootstrap components array is empty. And there will be additional check, like if the NgDoBootstrap method exists for module ref instance, and in our case it will be app module instance, right? Then this NgDoBootstrap method will be called, and the app ref instance that can actually bootstrap components, this instance will be passed as a parameter, which is very, very interesting. So it means that if I go to the source code of my application and remove completely bootstrap property, or just leave it as an empty array, doesn't matter, and if I have ngDoBootstrap method here, it means that this method should be called, right? So let's console log so far the stuff. And you can see that indeed it is called, but our application like blank and nothing has been rendered. And it makes sense, because now Angular delegates to us the bootstrapping logic, and we have to implement it inside ngDoBootstrap method. So if you remember, it provides the reference to app ref, so we can get it right here like that. And now I can use the bootstrap method in order to bootstrap the component that is supposed to be the root component in my application. So in my case, let it be the pro app component for now, and let's save it, and you can see that our application is back, which is cool, and it gives us a lot of flexibility, because the whole logic, how we bootstrap, which component should be bootstrapped, everything is up to us. For instance, if now you want to render them depending on, I don't know, the screen size, no problem with that. Just create some constant app and then do some simple check like inner
widths. If it's more than 300, then there will be, I don't know, pro version loaded. Otherwise, it will be the basic one. And then we provide this app constant as a value for the bootstrap method. And that's it. I save it, I go to the browser, and you can see on the white screen there were pro application rendered. And if I make it smaller and reload, you can see that the basic version was rendered. So this is the first option. Of course, it can be even more powerful, and you could inject some HTTP services, right? So we could inject HTTP client, but before I have to import it, of course. So HTTP client module comes here. Then we have to import it, of course, like that. Here we go. Now I can inject the HTTP client like that. And I can actually go to the server and pull some data. And depending on this data, I can render already the root component for my application. For instance, I could have some endpoint that checks if the user license is active or it is expired, so it could return the following object. And I could use this data in order to properly pick the application version that needs to be rendered. So I could do the HTTP call to this endpoint like that. Then I subscribe to it, right? And here in the callback, I would do the logic actually. So I can move this logic inside the callback. This console log I don't need anymore. Then what else we have to do? We have to get the data that will be returned from this callback. If you remember, it will be the following object. So first of all, let's define the return type right here. So it's going to be object with active property that is Boolean. Right. And now instead of this check, we can use our data active and save it like that. And it should work. And you can see that the application is properly working and the pro application has been rendered because this endpoint returned true. If it will return false, like it is now, then we should see the basic application loaded. So here we go. Well, basically, we have already implemented the feature that I described in the beginning of this video. However, there is always some room for improvement. And the first improvement we can do is to implement an appropriate interface for this lifecycle hook. Yeah, NgDoBootstrap is lifecycle hook, like you know it from Angular components, directives like ng on init, ng on changes, and so on, but it is applicable only for your app module. So it has a dedicated interface and you can implement it right here. It is called doBootstrap. So implementing this interface, you can be sure that this lifecycle hook is implemented properly. And the second thing we could improve is the following. So currently we have two applications. They have two different selectors. And in order to be bootstrapped, these selectors should be listed here inside index.html file. But it might be that you have more than two components. You can have, I don't know, 10, 20 components that might be bootstrapped, right? And in this case, it will be very, very problematic to list all of them inside the index.html. So it would be better to have only one single slot where the application will be rendered. So we could do something like, I don't know, some div, and we can give it some ID called container, or better, application, right? And we could render our Angular app inside this div. So how we can do that? Actually, the bootstrap method that comes from application ref has a second parameter called root selector or node. And if this parameter is provided, then the selectors of components, they will be kind of ignored and everything will be rendered in the node that is provided. So we could basically use document and get element by ID like that and say that it's going to be app, right? And provide this node. And now everything will be rendered within this div. So you can see in the source code, my application has been rendered inside div with ID app.
Alright guys, that was it. I hope this video was useful, and I would like to remind you one more time that please let me know in the comments if you like this approach when we do some code investigation and then slightly we come to some certain feature, or it would be better to do other way around as I usually do. So I would highly appreciate your feedback. Besides that, if you like my videos, the best way you can support my channel is to share this video with your colleagues and friends, or you can consider some of my video courses, and links will be in the video description so you can check it out in such a way you can support my channel and get some cool knowledge. Otherwise, I'm waiting for your comments, I'm waiting for your likes, and I wish you a productive week ahead. Stay safe and see you in the next video.